Hello guys, it is OSMN and welcome to Interactive Science. In today's video, I'm going to talk about chemical reactions. So, let's start. Before you watch the rest of the video, make sure you subscribe to the channel. By doing this, you will watch great videos like this one in the future. Living things, as you have seen, are made up of chemical compounds, some simple, some complex. But chemistry isn't just what life is made of. Chemistry is also what life does. Everything that happens in an organism, its growth, its interaction with the environment, its reproduction, and even its movements are based on chemical reactions. Chemical reaction is a process in which one set of chemicals transform into another set of chemicals. For example, iron and oxygen go through a chemical reaction to form rust. If we see chemical reaction from an atomic level, we see that atoms are breaking chemical bonds and making new ones. And these changes in chemical bonds cause a chemical reaction to take place. Elements that enter in a chemical reaction are called reactants. And elements produced by the chemical reaction are called products. For example, iron and oxygen are reactants. And the rust is the product. A key thing to remember is this, that mass and energy are conserved during a chemical reaction. By that, I mean that mass and energy are neither created nor destroyed during a chemical reaction. Let's take the example of mass. So you have a reactant which weighs around 23 grams. So the product will also weigh 23 grams. Now let's talk about the role of energy in a chemical reaction. In order to stay alive, organisms need to carry out reactions that require energy. Plants get that energy by trapping and storing the energy from sunlight in energy-rich compounds. Animals get their energy when they consume plants or other animals. Humans release the energy needed to grow tall, to breathe, to think, and even to dream through the chemical reaction that occurs when we metabolize or break down digested food. Energy is either released or absorbed whenever a chemical bond is broken or formed. This means that chemical reactions also involve changes in energy. Energy is released in forms of light, heat, and sound. Chemical reactions which absorb energy need a source of energy to start the reaction. On the other hand, chemical reactions which release energy occur on their own. They also need some energy to start the reaction. This type of energy is called activation energy. The fact that all chemical reactions need activation energy to occur plays a vital role to make our lives stable. Because if this wasn't the case, then all the books in the world would burn down, because the cellulose in the paper burns in the presence of oxygen. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then make sure you go down and subscribe to my channel and share the video and help me reach 100 subscribers in this month. So, before I end, I want to share some key terms with you. So, let's watch. A chemical reaction is a process that changes or transforms one set of chemicals into another. The elements which enter in a chemical reaction are called reactants. And the elements produced by the reactions are called products. The energy that is needed to get a reaction started is called the activation energy.